For he's been away on a 4-year government loan. For he's a fighter and a lover. All the girls better run for cover. Look out, old Norwood's coming home. When he gets back to his hometown, I wonder if he'll settle down. Even as a lad, he was hard to tame. Things around here ain't never gonna be the same. But he ain't changed, though he's a little older. Still wears a guitar around his shoulder. Look out, old Norwood's coming home. To his hometown, I wonder if he'll settle down. Even as a lad, he was hard to tame. Things around here ain't never gonna be the same. He ain't changed, though he's a little older. Still wears a guitar around his shoulder. Look out, old Norwood's coming home. Look out, old Norwood's coming home.
They think of us, Joe.
Well, maybe they got something. But I ain't so sure I'd want it.
Me neither. You clean that girl up a little bit, though, and you got a pretty good looking old hide there.
Howdy!
Howdy. We got a big load. My tires ain't so lasty, but I can carry one of you.
Well, I'm Norwood Pratt, and this is my buddy, Joe William Reese.
Hi. Well, climb in, whichever it's going to be.
As usual.
Okay, flip it.
Hells, you win again, Norwood. Get the... Hey, Tosho! What about that 70 bucks you owe me?
You'll get it back.
Been crop picking in California.
Oh, really?
Where you live?
I live in Ralph, Texas. It's just up the road a piece. It's in Bowie County. Well, I don't live right in Ralph. It's just the other side, close to Hooks. Ain't too far from Stamps, Arkansas.
You know, it's too bad y'all can't stop off a couple of days. We might scare up a good bird dog and go quail hunting.
Well, bye.
Good.
Bye-bye. Thank you for the ride.
Hi, Norwood. Welcome home.
Hello, Pete.
Me and my sister, Vernell.
Then how come you're out there and I'm in here?
Father!
Vernell!
Oh, Father! Ah! Oh,
You're gonna find a new girl in this sister of yours.
What's new about her?
Well, I ain't that big old crybaby I used to be hanging on your shirt tails. Bubba, we're married.
Married?
There wasn't time to let you know. Bubba, how come you didn't come home when Daddy died?
Well, I tried to get a leave, but it was just too far away to get back in time.
Oh.
Listen, it was a damn good all-round funeral. Your poor sister fainted twice.
Oh, everybody said Daddy looked so nice there at the end. You know, the funeral home, they scrubbed him all down with Baraxo and everything, and all that grease from the filling station was just gone.
Nah.
I never seen him look so clean. You know, I met Bill Bird here at the New Ralph Hotel Cafe.
She's still the best waitress they have.
Oh, he's from Nebraska.
That's right. Pilger, Nebraska. The exact center of the United States of America.
You're gonna enjoy him, Norwood. He's a mine of information.
I try to keep abreast. For instance, I would say that your hair is about 4 inches too long for marine regulations. And, sideburns?
Well, me and Joe Williams Reese was in sick bay about 2 months before we got mustered out last week. We had a case of the jungle scalp.
Oh.
They couldn't lay scissors on us. I grew me some hair. Does that bother you?
No, not at all.
Oh, I think it looks real nice.
However, it is a known fact that your most virile male is bald. You take your American Eagle. He's bald.
I got you some animal cookies.
Ah, welcome home. These are nice.
I noticed my car's got a flat tire on it.
Oh, it's only been down about a day or two.
Why didn't that mine of information of yours fix it, or at least jack it up off of the ground?
Well, Bubba, he's a disabled veteran.
Huh.
Of course, there's not too much wrong with him anymore, outside a little irregularity.
Well, his eating hand seems to be working all right. Bill Bird's got my car sounding like a two-cylinder tractor. I'm tired of working over at that Nipper Service Center.
But you hardly even started back yet. It's only been a week.
That's how I know I'm tired.
Bubba, why don't you go and call up one of your old girls or something?
All the good ones are either left town or married.
Well, what do you want to do?
I guess I'd sooner go over there and get on that Louisiana hayride show as anything.
Well, why don't you do it?
You can't just go over there to station KWKH and say I want to get on the air. You got to audition first.
Oh.
I have been reading a very interesting little piece in the Grit. There's a... I'm talking. There is a retired high school band director in Fort Lauderdale, Florida, who has trained his fox terrier to play Springtime in the Rockies on a mouth harp. A dog. Norwood, is that your copy of Batman I found in the bathroom?
I'm going into town, Vernell, as soon as I get cleaned up.
You gonna miss your supper.
I don't care. I know where I can get me a couple of good French fried clam burgers.
I'm trying to get along with him, Vernell, but he's like a child, especially about the Marine Corps, and they are highly overrated.
What did you say?
May I warn you that it's a federal offense to strike a disabled veteran?
But why don't you go on in the house now and take your bath?
Because, Vernell, there's no hot water left. There never is anymore. I'll go dirty.
Hot water. Small minds, small concerns.
Hello.
Hello, is this the Reese residence in Old Carthage, Arkansas?
Yes, it is.
I'd like to speak to Joe Williams Reese, please.
He is now believed to be in New York City. He just took off his uniform, threw it on the floor, and went lollygagging after some girl, if you ask me.
This is Norwood Pratt over in Ralph, Texas. I'd like to talk to him about some money he owes me.
I don't think we know any Pratts in Texas. There's a J.B. Pratt here. Comes to sweep out the courthouse. He used to go around sharpening lawnmowers.
Please, ma'am, do you have Joe Williams' address?
Thank you, now. What's wrong with you, Norwood? You feel all right?
Yeah, feel all right, Pete. Anything wrong with me, I'd go see a doctor. I think I'll mosey over to the roller rink, see if I can't pick up a little heifer looking for a ride home.
Boys, they're sure working hard, aren't they?
Yeah, like this delivering important telegrams.
They are stupid. And you and I are aware that the stupid do not inherit the earth, aren't they?
You know me?
I feel I do. I see your name right there over your pocket. Of course, you could have someone else's shirt on.
No, it's my shirt, all right. I'm getting about ready to turn it in.
My name's Frank. Glad to meet you. My brother Tillman and I are in mobile homes and coin-operated machines, also insurance. We have a debt collection agency in Texarkana. I'm sure you've heard of our self-serve car lots there. Grady Fring?
Grady Fring, the credit king?
None other.
No reasonable offer refused. Grady's going crazy and all that.
I'm also connected with a New Orleans talent agency. We seek out and recruit lovely young girls from all over the Mid-South, girls longing for a career. Who is that?
Which one?
Right around over there in the yellow skirt.
That's Croswell girl. Hi, Billy Joe.
Oh, hi, Norwood.
Well, she's a good skater, all right.
She is, and... What did her daddy do?
Daddy's dead. Mama works down at the Washatera.
How old is she?
About 56.
I mean the girl.
Oh, around 17, I guess.
Oh, I'd rather not tamper with them under 19 or 20. You will understand, Norwood, I am not necessarily looking for skating skills. Come on over here to my car. Let's have a drink. Maybe I can put you on to something. How would you like to make a trip to California?
Been to California, shipping out, shipping in.
Yeah, how about Chicago, New York, Atlanta?
New York?
Empire City, all expenses paid. Plus, and get this, $50 clear to you, found money right off the top.
What is this, some kind of contest?
Oh, it's a straightforward job offer. We ship off some of our surplus cars.
Pretty nice looking car you got there.
Now, you play cards right, son. Maybe you can have one like it before long.
This is somebody I'd like to see in New York, a buddy of mine, Joe Williams Reese. I guess I better stay around here, though, and try to get on that Louisiana hayride, Joe.
What would you do on the Louisiana hayride?
I flew around with a guitar and sang a little. I'd like to go down there and get me an audition.
Well, you should have said something about that, half of mine. I got quite a few friends in the music game.
You know anybody on the Louisiana hayride?
I know everybody on the Louisiana hayride.
Boy, that's what I'd like to get me a shot at.
Well, you might fare better than that field in New York. You know, audition for the really important people. I could arrange it for you, and I will. I'll contact my associate, Archie, there. But if there's any delay, you come right back here to me. I'll pick up the telephone to Shreveport and fix it up for you go on the hayride. I tell you what, you take that driving job for me, and I'll even do it before you go. That way, you'll have something to come back to. Here.
How would I get back from New York?
Well, you drive. That's our operation. You take the car up, bring one back.
Well, now, Mr. Fring.
Oh, Mr. Fring, nothing. Call me Grady.
like you didn't find yourself them clam burgers.
I had two.
Now hear this, Norwood. If you quit your nipper job and go chasing over to Shreveport on that Louisiana hayride foolishness and run out of money, Vernell and I will not, repeat, not be able to send you any. Vernell? Vernell, Norwood's throwing food. Did you throw this?
What is it?
You know perfectly well what it is. It's a cold pork sausage.
Yeah, I was wondering what that was. I saw this arm come through the window there and chunk something across the room.
Oh.
I thought maybe there was a note attached to it.
That window is closed.
Mm-hmm. Same arm closed it.
Throwing sausages. You could put a person's eye out like that. He should be made to apologize, Vernell. Vernell?
Bubba, why don't you apologize to him?
For what? Some stranger comes along and chunks a sausage through the house?
Oh.
All I saw was his sleeve. I'm gonna take my bath. My thumb hurts.
Vernell, I have just been reading this article about the seven danger signs of criminal tendencies. I have marked it for you to read. You're going to be very disturbed. Your own brother has the same personality profile as the Boston Strangler.
Well, I'll be a... Vernell! He's moved all my stuff out here on the windowsill. And my razor's got Bill Bird hairs in it. Vernell, dang it all, he's made himself a little home in here.
Norwood, why, you look like the Drango Kid. Yeah, how'd you get that high polish on your boots?
A little lighter fluid than island stocking.
Oh, that's nice. Now, here's your route. I got it marked. Stay on it. No main roads, but less chance of an accident that way. You know your point of delivery, Archie's Garage in Brooklyn. That's marked, too.
Does Archie know where I'm going for that audition?
He will take you there, personally.
And did you make that phone call to the Louisiana hayride?
Well, I said I would, and I did. You don't click in New York, you're all set to audition there when you get back. Now, here. Here's the title, pink slips, gasoline credit card, and the name of my brother Tillman, and your expense money.
$25? That ain't very much expense money.
Well, it's the usual. It's always been ample.
When do I get my $50 found money?
When you get to Brooklyn.
Why can't I have that now?
That's bad business practice. You're not even bonded, Norwood.
What does that mean?
It means you get your money when you get to Brooklyn.
Oh.
People willing to pay us for an opportunity like this. I got a couple of pretty nice surprises for you, Norwood. Here they come now.
You didn't say anything about two cars.
Well, you won't even know you're pulling anything with a new reflex tow bar. We just started using those, and they're dandies. Norwood? This is my brother, Tillman. Tillman, this here is Norwood. He's our new driver, and he's a dandy.
Grady's a cutter, ain't he? You do all he says now.
You can't even hear all he says.
Just to look at him, you wouldn't think Tillman was a very astute businessman, would you? Norwood, this is our extra added attraction, Miss Yvonne Phillips. She hails from Belzoni, Mississippi, by the way of New Orleans, and she is a dandy. Our talent agency discovered her, and we're sending her to New York. Thought you'd appreciate the company.
That's fine with me.
I hope you don't think that I'm going to go to New York with this country son of a bitch.
Hey, lady.
She'll cool off, Norwood. It's just me she's mad at. She thought she was going up in a Delta jet.
Oh, I wish Sammy Ortega was here. He'd break your arm.
Oh, yeah.
I wasn't talking to you, Peckerwood. But Sammy'd get to you, too, if he felt like it, you big-mouth country son of...
See him try.
That's enough out of you, young lady. Now you climb back in that car and wait.
Someday somebody's got to get you, Grady.
I said move. Full of gas and ready to go. When you get to Brooklyn, don't talk to anybody except Archie. He'll take care of everything, up to and including Miss Phillips there. Now, she's got her own expense money, boy, so don't let her pull anything. Of course, you're free to work out any personal understanding with her.
Maybe. She wants to. I don't think she wants to.
Well, I'll leave it to you. Drive with care. Don't get picked up by the cops. The laws are for our own protection. A car is just like a gun. In the wrong hands, it is an instrument of death. Bye.
Little roads, you get to see all the country. All the natural scenes and beauty.
Why don't you just keep
quiet? What's so funny?
Well, you're scratching your leg there. You look like you got ticks or tiggers or something on you. You know, we could make a pretty good trip out of this. I mean, I'd really like to be a good friend, Laverne.
I bet you would. My name is not Laverne, it's Yvonne. But I don't want you calling me nothing.
You know, Grady's right about that reflex tow bar. That little dude's really a wonder. Second feet stop we made. Don't you ever eat anything else?
I suppose what you guys better?
Can't beat a new grape. Look at that! Big old possum out there crawling through that hole in the fence.
Oh, son of a...
He looked like a big old slow rat.
What the hell's wrong with you? You think I want to see a possum crawling through some fence?
Oh, you missed him now anyway. He's probably out there in that field looking for some chow.
Oh, you are the biggest peckerwood bastard in the whole world.
Now, I don't like that kind of talk out of a girl, Laverne. You keep it up and you're going to get slapped right in the teeth. Now, what would your mama say?
You leave my mama out of this.
Well, I didn't aim to make you cry.
No, you couldn't make me cry, stud. I just wish that I was in Kelmet City, Illinois. Sammy Ortega, he's a bartender there, and he could get me lined up real easy. Well, you just crossed another state line.
It's the only way to get from one state to another, ain't it?
You know, under these conditions, they could put you in the federal penitentiary.
I ain't afraid of the Mann Act.
You are the peckerwood of all peckerwoods.
I'm getting pretty fed up with that peckerwood business, Laverne.
Stop calling me Laverne.
I don't see how in the hell anybody from Bell's Only, Mississippi could call anybody else a peckerwood anyway.
Well, look, for your information, I happen to have spent a lot of time in New Orleans, and I count that as my home.
You can live in Hong Kong, Kalamazoo, or Podunk, Iowa for 75 years. Bell's Only, Mississippi's still your home.
Look, don't you sit there and tell me what my home is.
Well, somebody ought to, woman.
Stop the car!
Going.
Butt-headed peckerwood!
Damn squirrel-headed dingbat.
Rock of Ages, cleft for me. Let me hide myself in thee. From thy wounded side which flowed, safe from wrath and make me new. While I draw
something in Calumet City, Illinois, right away. No wait.
Go ahead and go to Calumet City. I don't care. This Sammy Ortega, yours must be a real cannonball.
Mm-hmm. He's a bartender. We had a very good business association going in the near past. Hey. You know, I'm sorry. I talked to you so crabby.
It's all right.
Why don't you let me have one of these cars?
You mean let you steal it?
Well, how do you think Grady Friend got a hold of it? Or do you ever really think, Mr. Dumox?
These cars are hot?
They are about to burst into flames. Look out, you lunkhead!
I mean, they planned through to that stop sign, Uncle Lonnie. Come on!
We never will catch them now.
They can't hold a light to us. One car was torn, the other one. Come on!
Well, I'll drive.
Well, Mr. High Pocket, you just about got us killed that time. What do you plan to do next?
For a starter, I'm getting off of this here blacktop.
About 400 miles to Calumet City. I don't want any more to do with you or the car, Laverne. You can give this hot little number to Cannonball Ortega.
What are you doing? I didn't ask for wash and polish.
I'm wiping off my fingerprints. It's a proud day when the Marine Corps took them. Now they're up there in a drawer somewhere in Washington just waiting to do me in. When you ditch this car, you better wipe off your tracks, too.
Why, I was never in the Marines. Oh, a couple of camps, maybe.
You tell old Cannonball hi for me, okay?
You know, I never did get to hear you on that guitar. Adios.
Here we go bumming, searching near and far for the rainbow's end. Me and my guitar down the road a thumbing, trying to catch a star drifting in the wind. Norwood, the morning seems to whisper. Norwood, where you going, mister? I don't know. All I know is I gotta go, looking for tomorrow, through sunshine and sun. sorrow, laughter and rain. Me and my guitar, here we go a-bumming. Me and my guitar, happy when we're bumming.
Oh, I'm sorry, ma'am. I thought Joe Williams Reese lived here.
The Arkansas Traveler. Well, he did, but he's gone.
Hmm. Well, where'd he go?
Back to Arkansas, I guess.
Hmm. We was in service together. Howe Company, 3rd Battalion, 5th Marines. He owes me some money.
Well, he's gone. He was following this girl from his hometown. She was killing time up at Columbia College. And her folks said, back to New Carthage or no more allowance. Well, she went.
Oh, there's a girl named McKay. Joe Williams had her on his mind a long time now. Her granddad's big in soybeans down there. I'm Norwood Pratt. From Ralph, Texas. And down there, people ask people to come in.
Well, I've heard of Ralph. But I've never heard of Texas. Come on in.
Thanks.
Would you like some coffee?
Fine.
Here, I'll take that.
Thanks. Real nice place you got here. Boy, you can't beat a good cup of coffee.
Nope, you sure can't.
Wouldn't mind a sandwich either.
Want we'll some canned meat?
That'd be fine. You trouble with pests?
Had them on the run for a while, but they seem to have built up a tolerance.
We have pissmires down home.
Pissmires?
Yeah, sir. Big old ugly kind of ant. Real tasty stuff. What's it got in it?
I have no idea.
Beef tripe, beef hearts, pork, sausage, vinegar, flavoring, sugar, and sodium nitrate. Tripe. That's the gut part.
The lining of the stomach, actually. Hmm. I wish you hadn't read that.
Why?
Oh, sometimes it's better not to know things.
It's all meat. Meat's meat. Did you ever eat any gopher brains?
Hope not.
They're about like calf brains. Not really half bad if you don't think about it. The only bad part is cracking them little skulls open.
Mm-hmm. Gopher brains and tripe. Why do names have to be so repulsive?
Everything's got to have a name. There's not too much difference between ermine and vermin.
Well, when are you going to ask me what I'm doing in Joe Williams' place?
You never did tell me your name.
Marie.
Marie what?
I don't believe in last names.
Sound like you knew old Joe Williams pretty well.
Not as well as he wanted me to. Well, he may have been after that K, but he was after me, too.
Job's hard to come by in New York?
I don't know. I've never looked.
If you don't work, how do you pay for your bug dead?
Well, my daddy sends me a check every month. I'm a philosophy major at NYU. I don't go to class as much because I don't believe in philosophy.
Don't believe in philosophy, huh? Tell me, what do you not believe in most?
Well, if you really want to know, sex.
Sex? What do you got against that?
Sex. It's like the common cold. I see one more nude love scene in a film with all that rooting and grunting around, I'm gonna throw up.
Maybe you better not go to any more of them moving picture shows, huh?
Sex. It's like housework. Never stays done.
You want a 10-year guarantee, you buy a water heater. You know what I really got my mind set on is an audition. Post had one set up, but I don't think it'd be wise to go to Brooklyn right now. You know a place around here where a fellow might get one?
An audition for what?
Playing my guitar and singing.
Would it really make you happy to have someone hear you play this thing?
That's what I came to New York for. Well, that Joe Williams. I guess to get away from Ralph, Texas for a while.
Well, I think I know a place. And it's just about as far away from Ralph, Texas as you can get.
Which one's the talent scout?
That one over there. Go on, get up there.
I'd like to do a song about a guy that repossesses cars.
Yeah. Well, he's the slickest Mr. Clean that you've ever seen, and you can bet he's a smooth operator. And here's a black cone, black and black Naga hide, front and back Cadillac Eldorado. You better run, better run, better run, cause here come the repo man. And he's looking straight at you, and you know he's gonna catch you if you can. If you can, well, you can see him every night under neon lights, dressed just right to fit the situation. You never know he's from the farm with that check on his arm. They ain't nothing but a charming combination. Oh, wearing skin-tight suits and out-of-sight boots. Lord, he blows a lot of loot for decoration. But looks can deceive, cause when the man took his sleeve, he say, y'all, I gotta leave. It seems I got a previous obligation. Well, then he races to his Eldorado, stomps the accelerator, shoves his alligators in the carburetor, waving bye-bye, y'all. I gotta go. Here come the repo man. Here come the repo man. Oh, here come the repossession man. You better run, the bum, cause here comes the repo man. I said you better run, the bum, cause here comes the repo man.
Well, don't go to bummer about it. Come on, let's go.
Yeah.
Well, another day, another run at it.
No. You can have New York City, hon. I'm gonna head back home.
Well, it'll still be there in the morning. Keeps spend the night here if you like. In the bathtub, stupid. Men, they're all alike. Born with one idea and they'll die with it.
Women are different, huh?
Well, this one is.
The only thing different about you is you won't let on you're the same. You're scared.
And what am I scared of?
You were scared to read the label on that meat can. Might have been something there your mama told you to watch out for.
My mama never told me anything but nothing. And my father, he said a lot. He said, comb your hair, Marie. Lift yourself up a little, Marie. For what?
To hook yourself somebody.
So who needs somebody?
I'd say you do. I had you figured the minute you said Joe William was after you.
He was. He just didn't catch me.
Honey, what Joe William is after, Joe William catches. I'd say you ain't been caught. At least not often as you'd like to be.
Better get away from that bed, Norwood. Hey, this bathtub's too small for both of us.
Your daddy knew what he was talking about. Comb and do that mop of yours some good. That's a pair of pretty dirty feet there, too. And my daddy always said there's nothing like a nice warm bath to make a woman real giddy.
Marie, you're a funny little girl, Marie, in your funny kind of world, Marie, trying to do no wrong.
Hey, Norwood. Does that thing of yours play underwater?
No, ma'am. But I do.
Marie, you're a strange little one, Marie. Always on the run, Marie. Where do you belong? Sometimes you act just like a woman. Then you're childish as can be. Now should I treat you like a woman? Or maybe take you close my knee? Marie, you're a funny kind of girl, Marie. If I only knew your world, Marie, maybe I could play along with you, Marie.
Good run you made, young lady.
Well, I thought I had plenty of time, and then I saw your lights, and I just took off from Aunt Isabel's front porch of flying, and then the cord from my hair dryer came loose.
Can I help you?
Oh, thank you.
Thank you.
Well, them that wants it can have the state of Virginia. My, what a pretty brooch.
I'm a dental assistant. That's my 20-year pin.
Think of that, 20 years and anything. I haven't even lived that long. My, a dental assistant. I guess I'm cut out just to be a simple housewife.
Where are you from?
Swainsboro, Georgia. I'm on my way right now to Jacksonville, North Carolina. I'm going there to see Wayne.
Who's Wayne?
He's my intended. He's a Marine down there at Camp Lejeune.
What is he, an officer?
No, but I imagine he will be soon.
What is he now?
He's a PFC down there, the 2nd Marines.
You know when you're Wayne to be an officer? 1999.
All I know is he drives tanks down there.
Joe M. Reese used to be in tanks. That dude won a Silver Star. Boy, he used to have his pants cut down. He looked like a bandy rooster.
Did anybody ever tell you you were a chucklehead?
My hair's just a mess. Had it fixed so nice, now look at it.
Looks fine.
Just running for that bus. What are you wearing that cowboy hat for?
Keeping off the rain.
Ain't raining.
May we have your attention, please?
Gotta rain sometime.
Continental Trailways is now boarding for Indianapolis, Cincinnati, and Charleston. All aboard.
What are you hunting for?
Nothing.
What would you like?
A cup of coffee, I guess. I'll put in my own cream.
Okay.
I know why you're wearing that hat. You're a cowboy singer. Saw your guitar on the bus. Almost fell on my head.
Kind of fool around with it a little.
Ever make any records?
I plan to cut some platters when I get down to Shreveport.
Mm-hmm. Folks must be real proud of you. I mean, your wife and all.
Shoot, I ain't married.
I was supposed to be married 2 months ago.
Oh, to this captain in the Marines?
I said, no, we better wait. See, Wayne, he wanted to do everything right now. And after he thinks about it, he don't want to do it anymore.
Y'all sugar thing full?
Shoot, honey, we already too sweet as it is.
Attention, please. Continental Railway is now arriving from Atlanta.
She has an eye for you.
That sure is a pretty dress you got on.
Made it myself.
Oh.
Give me a sewing machine, I can do almost anything.
This Wayne of yours, you ever figure maybe he's got himself another girl?
Certainly not.
I've been in the Marines. He sounds like a runout to me.
Not Wayne. What's the matter with you? You're always doing things.
Well, here we are in Richmond.
What's Richmond got to do with anything?
Well, it's where I make a change from Memphis. You head on down to Jacksonville, North Carolina. I think I'll get my ticket changed.
To where?
I've never been to North Carolina. Yeah. Just think I'll do that.
Wayne, he's a handsome devil, all right. Every girl down home tried to get him. I'm the one who did. He'd favor rock cuts and a lot of his neck was filled out more. I was afraid of this. I was afraid as soon as I sat down here, you'd think I was looking for love on a bus. I mean, how could I be? I already found it. Now, you're bound to get a bad opinion of me.
Why?
Well, letting you do that. There was this witch I saw in a movie once, and she stole this child from a baby buggy in front of a 10-cent store, and she's doing just what you're doing. Like she was, you know, testing it to see if it was plump enough. I don't remember what she had in mind. I've been grabbed and wrestled around a lot of ways before, but this is a new one on me. Now, Norwood, stop it. I mean it.
Well, you got a neck I wouldn't mind biting.
Well, what's your all-time favorite Tammy Wynette record?
Think about it.
Mine, Stand By Your Man.
Mine, too.
I'd like to hear you sing sometime. What's your singing style like?
Well, did you ever hear Lefty Frizzell sing, I Love You a Thousand Ways?
I've never even heard of Lefty Frizzell.
I don't guess there's any way to explain it, then.
Why don't you sing something now?
Not on the bus.
Yeah, well, you could do it soft. Please?
For you?
I look inside your eyes and find a little girl whose dreams have turned to sand somewhere along her way. But if you'll close your eyes and step inside my world, I'll take you by the hand. We'll find a brand new day. I'll sing you a morning with laughing bluebirds. I'll sing you a fairy tale full of ribbons and crepe paper words. I'll sing you a rainbow you can keep for your own. I'll sing you a morning. I'll paint you a song. So won't you come along?
Awful.
Oh, that's a war wound. I fell off a water truck in Quezon.
Did you get a Purple Heart?
Nah.
I should have got a medal.
Nah. They don't give medals for things like that, unless you're an officer. They give them to each other. Boy, I sure don't think much of this Wayne changing his mind on you.
Well, some folks call his family trash, but, well, I've been to their house and his mom keeps her floor as clean as any shirt you got in your drawer.
I think a woman should go chasing after a man just because his mama keeps a clean house.
Well, he's the kind always do the right thing in the end.
Who's gonna tell him what the right thing is?
What attracts you to me?
Well, you're about the right size. Your hair, his hair color's not all dyed up. Pretty brown eyes. Sure do taste good.
I'm promised to somebody else, you know.
You're not married yet.
I almost am. And I'll thank you to remember it.
Boy, you seen one Marine Liberty party, you seen them all.
Them old boys act like them their shorts is bunching up on them.
Face's all red. It's your fault.
Now, I ain't got all that stiff a beard.
Well, how'd my face get like this then?
I don't know. I can use a regular thin Gillette 5 times. It looks like the bus is going out to the base. You sure you want to be on it?
If I wasn't, I wouldn't be here in the first place, now would I?
You know, my bus don't leave for Memphis till 1 o'clock. I'll be here at 12:45. Right here by the map.
Why would I want to know where you're going to be at 12:45?
Well, that's what time my bus leaves for Ralph, Texas, where I live. It's just beyond Texarkana. If you and Miss Wayne don't get married this afternoon, you can come back here and maybe we can do something tonight. I can lay over.
Well, when you get back home, you think of Rita Lee Chipman sometimes.
Okay, I'll be here at 12:45.
I almost wish I was coming back to find out if you will be.
Closed, Hat Man.
Closed? On a beer day like today? That ain't human.
Let him in, Ernestine.
Well, you're the last one till I finish varnishing this bar.
May I have another beer, Ernestine?
Sure.
Why aren't you staring at me? That's what you're supposed to do. Tell me, what is your IQ?
About 125. But you only need 120 to get an officer's candidate school. Thanks.
I don't suppose you've ever heard of Edmund B. Ratner, the world's smallest perfect man?
No, can't say as I have.
You will. I have plans.
All right. I'm Norwood Pratt.
Norwood, here's to my plans.
Move it, gentlemen.
Are you from around here?
No one's from around here. I'm in showbiz.
Oh, with the circus?
I was once. With the best ones, too. I was on my own since I was a boy. My father sold me when I was a pup.
Sold you?
Yeah. When Curly Hill came to town with his animal show, he saw me and asked my father would I like to wear a Buster Brown suit and ride an Irish wolfhound.
Okay, gentlemen, move it.
Come on in, boys. Can't do better for 2 bits. If you don't like girly movies, there's little old Barry can shoot with electric rifle.
Hey, Edmund, look at this. College-educated wonder chicken. I guess you have to ask your questions out loud, huh?
And I would suggest that you put it as simply as possible.
Okay, Hen. Here's the question. I ain't gonna ask that chicken that question. She looks crazed anyway.
Nonsense. A trooper's always on. Put the nickel in. I'll ask the question.
Okay.
Will I go to Hollywood? Charity endureth all things. That's hardly a yes or no.
The least they could do is get her out of the sun. I said I'd be here at 12:45, and you said you wouldn't. Hey, what are you bawling about?
No, but I want you to know one thing. I like you. And if I was around and you were sick, I'd look after you and bathe you.
Shh, not so loud. What happened at the base with you and Miss Wayne to make you cry?
Well, I'm crying for Wayne. See, I just found out I don't care for Wayne no more. I jilted him.
Well, you going back home to Swainsboro, Georgia?
No, I couldn't face the people, all those girls. Nobody down home ever believed I walked out on Wayne.
Where are you going?
Well, I thought maybe my sister in Augusta. I might get into beautician school. I know one thing for sure, I'm gonna get out of this town.
You can come with me if you like.
Come along with you and do what?
Come along. Nobody has to know what they're doing all the time, do they?
Meet Lee Chipman does.
Are you gonna come with me to Ralph, Texas or not?
Must be out of my mind. I mean, all I know about you is your name and where you come from, and you used to work at a place called the Nipper Service Center. You got a prickly beard. But yes, I want to come with you, Norwood.
Give me your ticket and I'll get it fixed. Oh, by the way, that midget over there is going to be traveling with us.
Oh, my goodness, you mean him?
Yeah, his folks sold him when he's a kid. You be good to him now, okay? Come on. Hey, Edmund. This here is Rita Lee.
A pleasure, I'm sure.
You two stay here and get acquainted. If I'm not back before that bus pulls out, y'all get on it and save me a seat, okay?
Well, where's he going with my shopping bag?
Come get this chicken.
What for?
Give her a shot.
Wait a minute. I gotta ask the man owns that chicken about a shot. Hey!
Dominicker chicken. And it's on my clothes.
Norwood, how diverting.
Norwood, I don't want this chicken on my clothes.
Don't you like chicken?
They have mites and they're filthy things, and all they do is mess up the yard.
Well, this one's that trainer.
Norwood, I don't want this chicken on my clothes.
I have plenty of room over here.
Okay.
Get that chicken anyway.
Her name's Joanne. Edna and I was down at this place. Oh, hon, it's a long story. And I'll tell you later. I'm tired.
sing you a morning with laughing bluebirds. I'll sing you a fairy tale full of ribbons and gray paper words. I'll sing you a rainbow you can keep for your own. I'll sing you a morning, I'll paint you a song. I'll sing you a meadow with marshmallow skies. I'll sing you a puppy doll with a pink tongue and big loving eyes. I'll sing you a sunset that glows all night long. I'll sing you a morning, I'll paint you a song.
Going over to the hotel. I'll go call Joe Williams. Meet y'all there in a minute.
Okay.
All righty.
Hello, Joe Williams Reese.
Yes, speaking. Who is this?
This is First Sergeant Brown down at headquarters, Marine Corps. We've been looking over our books here, and it seems we owe you some money.
Yeah? How much?
Well, the books say $2,060.
Well, it ought to be more.
Well, I told the Commandant that you would probably want to give it to the Navy Relief Fund, since you never did give any on payday.
Norwood, where the hell are you?
I'm over at the bus stop in Old Carthage.
What are you doing there?
I'm just passing through. Thought I'd stop to see about that $70 you owe me.
Well, I got it for you. Listen, you're just on time. We're having a family fish Friday night.
Hey, great.
It'll take me about 20 minutes to get there. You'll be over in front of the Beau Rivage Hotel.
Hey, okay. Look, I got some more...
We'll bust a watermelon later on. Spit seeds on the girls and make them cry.
Hey, okay, but I got some... Joey.
God dang, no.
How are you doing, girl?
All right. No, this is Kay.
Ah, I guessed as much.
Hello, Norwood. You know, you're exactly what I expected.
Hey, that's a pretty nice car you got there.
The way she drives, nobody in town won't show it. Come on, hop in.
Well, there's this. I got some more people with me.
Well, bring them along.
Well, one of them's a girl. Met her a couple days ago.
That was fast work. What'd you do, pick up on a bus?
Is there supposed to be some special place you get a girl?
No, I guess they're just wherever you find them.
Hey, this one's good looking. You never seen with a girl look this good before. She's the pick of the litter. The other one was a midget.
I didn't get that.
The other one's a midget.
You mean a short guy?
I mean, well, not just short. He's real short. He used to be with the circus. You know, his folks sold him.
To you?
Oh, hell no, not to me. They sold him when he was a boy. He's 48 years old now.
Whatever you say, Norwood. Anybody else? Any Japanese exchange students?
You don't believe this. I got a chicken with me.
Look, maybe I better charter a bus for your group.
Oh, this ain't a regular chicken. Her name's Joanne. I mean, I wouldn't be just running around with a plain old hen.
No, I'm sure there's a reason why you're traveling with a chicken, but I don't know what it is.
Okay, gang, come on out.
Let's
Norwood, if only our old drill sergeant could see you now.
The dogwood trees and the southern breeze set my mind spinning. This is the only life I've ever known. Surrounded by the evening and the kind of folks I love. Oh, it's good, Lord, it's good to be down home. Down home. Smiling faces shine like the morning dew. My fondest memories lie here. I was born here and I'll die here with my heart full of happiness and you.
You know, cooking catfish is a real art, Mr. Reese. You handle that meal sack and grease just right.
My son-in-law don't talk much.
Dad don't think there's much worth saying. In fact, he don't even like being around people.
That's the greatest problem in the world today, overcrowding. But I have the solution. My plan is to breed small. I have dipped into history. The dinosaurs went, the mouse survived. You are the dinosaurs. And if my plan is adopted, midgets like myself could rule the world. Let me tell you, there'll be some sweeping reforms.
I'll use these leftover cornbread balls for my laying hens. Mr. Reese, did you buy me some new hens? Well, I was looking out the bathroom window a while ago, and I thought I saw a gray one out there with a dress on.
That one belongs to Norwood. It's his wonder chicken he brought down from North Carolina.
Well, I don't think they should let a chicken travel on a bus. It's unsanitary.
Oh, Joanne was real good. She only forgot herself once.
Don't mind Kate, folks. She tries. But she thinks she was born here in Arkansas by some terrible mistake.
I got some Poland China brood sows I'd like to show you before it gets dark.
You know, those are the first words I've heard him say since I've been home.
I know it's you, but you don't know it's me.
I was looking for Rita Lee.
Did you think she was sharing my room? I gave up that nonsense long ago. She's next door.
I didn't hear any knock, Norwood Pratt. If I had, I wouldn't have said come in. Not at this hour of the night.
Well, I got up to see how Joanne was.
Well, how was she?
She ate a couple of worms. I thought I'd better look in on you. Thought you might be scared of the rain.
You're always talking about rain when it isn't raining. What if it was? Would you keep it off me?
Maybe.
Now, you just wait a minute. I don't like any tricks played on me.
Why, shoot, that ain't much of a trick. Turning off a light. I bet Joanne could do it.
You know, I once read a true story about a girl that fell in love with a good-looking novelty salesman, and he took her to Louisville, Kentucky. And then he left her there. A little motel with a swimming pool out in the front.
She didn't know a soul in Louisville, Kentucky, and she wound up walking the street shivering with fear.
Did you go in that pool any?
Well, some lady got her from the courthouse and put her into an institution, and that's where she wrote the story from, it said.
That's a sad story.
Well, it teaches you a lesson that you can't trust a novelty salesman or anybody.
You can trust me.
I never would take you to Louisville, Kentucky.
Stop fumbling, Norwood. You don't know, but you're acting just like that salesman. Now, you go back to your own room.
I tell you, it's fixing to rain like it never rained before.
You know what? I like that. But I got no business liking it.
Well, you're all through with General Wayne, ain't you?
No, not quite. Quit it. I've got something to tell you, and I don't want you looking at me. I'm pregnant.
The hell you say?
I figure I'm 3 months along. I'm very good at math, too. I got all B's.
What'd you walk out on Private Wayne for, then?
He did the walking. He said an awful thing, too. He said he didn't even believe the baby was his, and I couldn't go back to Swainsboro. My father beat the living daylights out of me.
Well, what'd you think I'd do?
Well, you were so good to that chicken. Maybe it wasn't honest of me not to tell you right off, but I had to go somewhere else fast. I didn't know what to do.
At least you did something. More than most people would have done.
Suppose you don't want me to go with you to Ralph, Texas anymore.
Well, I guess here's about where your traveling salesman would back out.
If it's a girl, I'm gonna call her Benita, and if it's a boy, well, I have made up my mind.
I'll let you come along with me and Joanne if you want to.
Why?
Don't really know. Somebody ought to bust this Wayne's clavicle for him.
I don't suppose you have any intentions of...
Of what?
Of marrying me.
That's right, Ridley Chipman, I ain't.
Well, then. There's just one thing I want to get cleared up. I don't want to go with you if you ever start talking like Wayne did about getting rid of the baby. Like it was a cat with two tails.
It's talk like that that gives the Marines a bad name.
You never did say why you let me go along.
Hell, I don't know. Guess it's because you're the only girl I ever met that... I don't know. You know, you don't look 3 months pregnant.
And don't you tell me about my tires. Joe William always does.
You ain't having that bad universal joint you got there, neither.
What's that?
That's a little doodad on the end of your drive shaft. Right there's where you got trouble.
Only there? Where's Joe William? You know, I'm sorry to see you go, Norwood. And Rita Lee, too. It's funny the people pick out, isn't it?
Joe William's a pretty good old boy when you get right down to it. You gonna marry him or what?
Well, I've tried the or what.
Ooh. You still don't know whether he's good enough for you or not?
Mm-mm. Ain't that hell?
Ain't what hell? War, buddy.
Love.
Different people, different hells. I put a fresh dress on it for traveling.
Here.
Rita Lee be out in a minute. Where's Edna?
The mighty midget? He got me up at 6 o'clock to take him in and catch a train.
Well, he could have said goodbye.
On the way to town, he laid on me for a loan.
How much did you give him?
Not a quarter. I'd never see it again.
Ah, I got him down for a pretty nice little guy.
When he takes over the world, you think he's gonna put a word in for us dinosaurs?
Sure.
Well, I don't. We're probably right at top of his S list.
Joe, William, I really don't know how to thank you for your gracious hospitality, and I ain't gonna even try.
Just you and Mr. Norwood Pratt come back, we can stay longer.
I don't know what's got into my old hens. They're laying like they was crazy. They're gonna hurt themselves.
You've been real good to us, Grandma Witchcoat, and I'm sure Norwood thinks likewise.
I certainly do, ma'am. And I bet Joanne had a big time, too, didn't you?
You're a sweet little girl, and you know how to mind your manners. If I had time, I'd give you a good talking to, Missy. That boy looks shifty-eyed to me.
And Grandma knows a seducer when she sees one.
Sooner or later, I'm gonna have to get around to settling down. Find me a woman and get me some land back in my hometown. Well, I got my eye on an acre and a quarter, not very far from the Arkansas border. Sooner or later, I'm gonna have to get around to settling down.
Got a hold of Vernell. They'll be over in a little bit. Sure hope that connecting rod holds up.
See what I got you, sister?
You didn't have to buy her nothing, huh?
Well, girls love presents. Think it's the right color?
It's the right color for Bill Bird. He likes anything to do with sleeping.
Do you favor your sister, Vernell? Oh, yes, you do, son. What's she doing in this junkyard?
That's where we live. Of course, I cleaned it up a lot since this picture.
Well, I sure do wish we'd get where we're going. My eyes hurt. I guess I saw too much.
Hi!
Vernell!
Vernell, I'd like to meet Rita Leigh Chipman. She's from Swainsboro, Georgia.
Well, I do.
She's going to visit us for a few days.
Just a short one. I know what they say, you know, after 3 days fishing, the guests begin to smell.
Well, it's real nice to meet you. I'm Mrs. Vernell Bird, and this here's my husband, Mr. Bill Bird.
How do you do?
Oh. Bird, that's a pretty name for a name.
It is.
I guess you think it's kind of queersome, me being here with Norwood like this and everything. Oh, no, not at all. Why, once he brung home a wrestler that came down with the mumps the very next day. You remember? What's that there?
That's Joanne. She's been to college. Which is more than I can say for anybody else around here.
Hey, Bubba, what happened on your trip?
Nothing much. I collected that $70 from Joe Williams Reese for one thing.
Norwood, stop the car. Stop the car. I have to get out. Good night. She's throwing up, Bubba. Wonder what's the matter with her.
Well, I think they call it morning sickness only. I didn't know they had it at night, too.
Well, this beats that wrestler you brought home.
Bubba, you mean... You mean that...
Ooh. I'm sorry, I guess we haven't been eating too well.
Maybe it's a change of water.
Sure.
Hey, Bubba. How pregnant is she?
What's so important about that?
Well, you know what I mean. Have you known her long enough?
I've known her just about as long as I've known that chicken. I met her on the bus to Richmond.
Finding a girl that cute on a bus, you should know something was wrong with her.
You mind your own business, Bill Bird. If you got any outside of eating and sleeping and snooping.
Good night. Look it. There's somebody out in our front yard.
It's a rented car from Grady Fring, Jew Wheelett. Look like your name might be Wayne something or other.
Wayne T.E.B. Walker. And you couldn't be anybody but somebody named Pratt. Only you don't own any filling station. You don't even work there. I ask around.
Gracious, if it isn't Wayne.
Don't joggle the chicken.
Oh, so that's what you're in, poultry. Rita Lee would never marry you, chicken plucker.
Did I hear you say marry?
Norwood, I lied to Wayne. I wrote him a postcard and I told him you proposed to me and... Well, I couldn't stand her, no. My heart was broken, and I also told him that you own a filling station, too.
Rita Lee, get in my car. I'm taking you back with me. We can just about make it legal before I have to ship out.
Well, I don't think I'm going with you, Wayne.
Oh, you give me a big shock, but common sense come to my aid. You always been too gone on me to mess with anybody else, so it couldn't be anybody's kid but mine.
I do believe you are the most big-headed man in the most big-headed branch of the service.
I just know my own powers. Now, which of this stuff is yours?
Don't touch her stuff.
Repeat that kindly.
Do not touch her stuff.
Look, nobody's taking over my girl and my kid. You don't want to stay here with this ground pea, do you?
What'd you call me, wool hat boy?
Ground pea.
I wouldn't hit you, Marine Stark.
Oh. I said get in that transport.
You must think you're the last man on Earth and the moon, too.
We now know that there's no life on the moon. It's a dead planet. Just rocks and dust.
I don't think I even want you near my baby, Wayne Walker.
Your baby? You didn't exactly get it single-handed.
He whooped me. He got the best of me.
Oh, Norwood, no, he didn't. No, he didn't. Oh. Norwood, what should I do?
You do what you want to do, huh? I ain't telling you to go, and I'm not asking you to stay.
It's a blue suitcase and a white shopping bag.
Seems quite natural. The Army carrying the Marines.
You've been carried every day of your life, Bill Bird. Don't get me any more riled.
Oh, Bubba. Oh, gracious sakes. I completely forgot to tell you. Somebody's been calling for you here all day long. I wrote their number down right here, and they said you should call them any time of day. Oh, I don't know who it was. Boy, am I tired. It's been quite a day.
Louisiana hayride? Yeah, that's Norwood Pratt over in Ralph, Texas. Okay, I'll wait. I guess that liar Grady Fring told the truth once anyway. Yes, sir. Yes, Norwood Pratt. Right. I'm leaving right now. Okie doke. Bye.
Bubba, Louisiana hayride. Well, I think you'd be jumping for joy.
Somehow that audition just don't mean as much as I thought it would.
You know, Bubba, maybe it's better you don't have that little Rita Lee with you. She'd probably just be throwing up all the way to Shreveport.
Seven up would settle her stomach.
I could have settled her stomach.
Goodness sakes, you aren't going to take that chicken with you, are you?
I don't trust her here around Bill Bird. He could just eat her.
Huh?
Besides that, I've never seen a college-educated chicken on television. If I don't make it on a hayride, maybe she will. Bye-bye.
Sure hope you make it.
I'm betting on the chicken.
This time.
Anywhere away from that Wayne Walker.
What changed your mind so fast? Come on, get in if you want to go with me.
Where to?
Now, if that makes any difference, maybe you better not get in.
It don't make any difference.
You've been an awful lot of trouble to me, but it hadn't seemed to bother me that much. That's about as close to a proposal as you're going to get from me, Rita Lee. Do you understand?
Yes. Norwood, you know what I want to do?
What?
I want to live in a trailer and listen to you play and sing all night.
I've got everything a man could ever need. I got dreams to dream and songs to sing in the morning. I got hands to hold my baby child and eyes to watch my woman smile. I've got everything a man could ever need. Now my working day seems shorter than it ever did before, and the evening breeze gets cooler day by day. And the morning sun is always shining down on my back door, and your laughter washes all my cares away. And there's not a day goes by that I don't look up to the sky and humbly thank the good Lord up above for bringing you to me in time to make me realize that all a poor man really needs is love. I've got everything a man could ever need. I got dreams to dream and songs to sing in the morning. I got hands to hold my baby child and eyes to watch my woman smile. I've got everything a man could ever need. I've got everything a man could ever need.